I am sorry. I'm just reading some of the news today, and some of it I just it cannot, absolutely cannot be true. Disney is debuting its first boy princess with chest hair to teach a powerful lesson about gender bias.
Okay, why not?
Why not? A Disney animated series has introduced its first male princess, complete with chest hair, to share an important bias about gender bias. A recent episode on the Disney XD channel animated series Star vs. the Forces of Evil, the character Marco transforms himself into Princess Marco for his visit to St. Olga's Reform School for Wayward Princesses, where he's given an honorary degree. However, before Marco is able to confess that he is pretending to be a princess, the school's evil headmistress, Miss Heinous, outs him as a boy by exposing his single curly chest hair that is hidden underneath his purple gown. Turdina isn't a princess. She's a boy, Miss Heinous tells the audience, but the headmistress's revelation doesn't affect the princess's favorable views of Turdina. I think it's important to point out that the root of Turdina is turd. That doesn't prove anything. Princesses can be hairy, one princess in the crowd responds, while the hairy princess adds, yeah, we believe in you, Turdina. Overwhelmed with guilt, Marco admits that he has been lying to them and removes his gown to show that he is indeed a boy. Miss Heinous argues that Marco's lie is proof that she needs to be running St. Olga's. However, the other princesses refuse to see gender as a factor in deciding who can be a princess. He can be a princess if he wants to, someone else shouts, and another princess declares, Turdina is a state of mind. The Progressive Show is the first animated series created by a woman, Darren Nefsky, and earlier this year, the program featured Disney's first same-sex kiss on the Disney Channel. In an episode which aired in March, a gay couple can be seen sharing a kiss for the first time in the history of the Walt Disney Company. Walt would be so proud. He would. I know Walt liked to get into all of the sexual issues.
That's what he wanted to do, yeah.
He was like, when he was doing the mouse and Mickey Mouse, he was like, you know, let's really teach kids about sex.
That was basically, yeah. I mean, it was a very early effort at porn. That was what the Disney company was built on.
It was.
As much sexual escapades as you can, as you can portray. Yes.
And let's do everything we can to turn the culture inside out and upside down. That was his biggest.
Do you ever see the unrated version of Steamboat Willie?
No, I have not.
Oh, man. They just go to town. It's incredible.
You should hear.